Spiritual dressing. Some of you are sitting here dressing is very important. The price you put on your life, that is what people pay for. If you always price yourself cheap, if you price your life very low, people classify you very low. Spiritually, if you are wearing a garment of prosperity, everything you will do, you prosper. If you are dressed spiritually for presidency, everywhere you go, without even telling them you are a president, they classify you, look like a president. If God classifies you as spiritually rich, everywhere you go, you might be very poor, but people classify you to be rich.
So your missus shall say, "Oh, you're the fool." Every upper now, you miss. Baby, be a baby, be a. Nipa, anybody, anybody, what say, "Oh, you're the fool."
That is why, when when Jesus Christ invited blind Bartimaeus to come to him, when blind Bartimaeus was wearing the clothing of shame, the Bible says when Christ called him, he took off the clothing and walked to Jesus because he was walking into praise and glory.
And then in Hebrew, Jesus Christ offered the friend for Bartimaeus. No, 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 Jesus Christ offered no, 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 no,
you see, Jacob had so many children, but the Bible said he sewed a special clothing for Joseph because he saw that he was the leader of the family.
Papa Jacob, our mother, Bray, now so on here, see, I tell you, Papa, a man, my friends, and Joseph, Essence, and all, any money, you know, or nobody won't come.
So many of you are wearing the wrong clothing.
Young women, why are not telling us, and young from Swatan, and
you say you are struggling to be rich, but you are wearing a clothing of poverty, so everything you do, you will suffer poverty.
Yet, the apprentice say, you see, now so at a reason, and you're here, and it will be a year, next year, or here.
So many of you spiritually, you are wearing the wrong clothing. So when people see you, they hate you, they classify you, they call you names, because that is how they see you to be. Because the clothing you are wearing is the wrong one.
I said,
so many of you are struggling to be somebody, but you are not getting there because spiritually the clothing you are wearing is the wrong one. This evening, the Lord is laid on my heart to prophesy over your life that any bad clothing, any clothing of shame you are wearing, any clothing of poverty you are wearing, you are about to take it off and wear the clothing of the Lord's glory. You qualify for a job, but you are applying for it. They are not calling you or they are not hiring you because the clothing you are wearing is the wrong one. But I prophesy that after this service, any wrong clothing you are wearing, any clothing of shame upon you, any clothing of embarrassment upon you, it shall go off, 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 it shall go off. Somebody say,
I don't think I'm a quiet as a few men in the enemy said, and I'm your fire, you know.
Somebody in the eyes and say, you.
You.
I did not hear you. Are you sleeping already? Look at somebody and tell the person, you.
You.
I prophesy to you.
I prophesy to you.
That after today's service, any wrong clothing,
any bad clothing,
upon your life,
is
getting out now.
It's getting out
now. It's getting out now. Zachariah 3:1. Yes.
And he showed me Joshua, the high priest.
He said, and he showed me, listen to the language very critically. He showed me Joshua, the high priest. Man, go on.
Standing before the angel of the Lord.
He was standing, that is a high priest, who was standing before the angel of the Lord. It meant that this man has to be surrounded by the glory of God. Man, read on.
And Satan standing at his right hand.
Even though he was standing right before the Lord God, he was standing before the right God. Satan was standing on his right hand side. Why? Go on.
And the Lord said unto Satan.
And the Lord said unto Satan.
The Lord rebuke you, O Satan.
May the Lord rebuke you, O Satan.
Even the Lord that has chosen Jerusalem rebuke you.
He said, even the Lord who has chosen Jerusalem rebuke you. Let me read on quick.
It's not this a brand plucked out of the fire.
He said, this man, listen to the language, this man has been pulled from the fire of God. Amen. Now Joshua was somebody on fire for God, but he has a problem. Go on.
Now Joshua was clothed with filthy garments.
The problem is that the man was dressed in the wrong clothing. Even though he was standing before God, the Bible said he was dressed in a filthy clothing. Filthy clothing is your poverty. Filthy clothing is your poverty. Filthy clothing is your sickness. Even though you are blessed with the hand of God upon you, somewhere, somewhere, the clothing you are wearing is not meant for the occasion. Have you seen somebody that said she wasn't dressed for the occasion? Spiritually, I see so many of you sitting here, you are dressed for the wrong occasion. I said tonight, spiritually, the dress you are wearing is not the one you are supposed to wear. The devil has a clothing of poverty upon you. The devil has a clothing of barrenness upon you. The devil has a clothing of shame upon you. Everywhere you go, shame and disgrace follow you. Because the devil has a clothing of filthiness upon you. And because the devil has a clothing of filthiness, the devil is always standing by your side. And because you are wearing a clothing of filthiness, the devil is always around you. And people always find the wrong things about you. You always observe that people are always pointing to the wrong things about you. Because you are wearing the wrong clothing. But today that wrong clothing of poverty is about to come off. I said that wrong clothing upon you, that wrong clothing upon you, that wrong clothing upon you, it's coming out today, 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 it's coming out, 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 say amen. Look at somebody one more time and tell the person the clothing is coming off. Tell the person we see him that that clothing is coming off. Tell the person another time that clothing is coming off.
Show me an black chance, sir, or here, and we are Saturn, Saturn, and a row, Saturn, and a row. Show me an black chance.
So many of you, you have worked hard, you have worked 2 jobs, but you don't even have a dime in your bank account. The reason is that you are wearing a clothing of poverty or indebtedness. Ma'am, read on. And read with power, please.
Now Joshua was clothed with filthy garments and stood before the angel.
He stood before the angel.
And he answered and spoke unto those that stood before him, saying,
He answered unto those that are standing before him, that
take away the filthy garment from him.
Take away the filthy garment. I see your filthy garment coming off.
Amen.
I said, I see your filthy garment coming off. I see your filthy garment coming off. I see your filthy garment coming off. It is coming off right now. 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 It is coming off. 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 Take it off. Because the presence of God is upon you.
Amen.
No curse, no divination, no witchcraft, no bad clothing, no indebtedness shall have any power over you. But today I see the glory of God coming down. I see the glory of God coming upon you. I see the glory of God coming upon you. I see the glory of God come upon you. Lift up your hands and say, I receive it. Lift up your hands and say, I receive it. Lift up your hands and say, I receive it. You are receiving 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 it.
And unto him he said, behold, I have caused your iniquity to pass from you.
He says, I have caused your iniquity. The iniquity is the bad clothing. It's the filthy clothing. It's the clothing of disgrace. God said, I have caused your filthy clothing to pass away from you. It is as if somebody, God is prophesying to somebody in this house that your disgrace are going away. Your poverty is going away. Your sin is going away. Your trouble is going away. Your frustration is going away. You are receiving the blessings of God. 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 No more poverty. No more sickness. No more disease. No more infirmity. No more poverty. No more indebtedness. Receive it. 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 Amen. And Jesus Christ called him from death and he came out.
May yes, who's a friend if you are not praying?
The Bible says Lazarus was tied down.
Next verse I said, but Lazarus, now what you to man to children.
They have tied down with death clothing.
What the woo and chaman at children?
Jesus Christ said, loose him.
And I yes, it's a one son in
and let him go.
Now my uncle.
Today, if you are sitting here with any bad clothing, if you are sitting here with any clothing of that, I command you to be loose. Be loose in the name of Jesus. 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 Amen. That clothing you wore to the house spiritually.
Sir, I was
as I was preaching,
sir,
I saw the angel of God surrounding you with a new clothing. I see the glory of God coming upon you now. I said, I see the glory of God coming upon you now. I see the glory of God coming upon you now. I see the glory of God coming upon you. I see the glory of God coming upon you. I see the glory of God coming upon you. Receive it. 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 Receive it.
Jesus
Christ called blind Bartimaeus. Blind Bartimaeus was covered with shame and guilt.
Now, Bartimaeus did what he was saying.
He was covered with a clothing of shame. But as he lifted up, the Bible says he shook it off. He shook the clothing of shame away. Today, anything upon you, come on, let me see you shake it off. Anything upon you, shake it off. Anything upon you, shake it off. Anything upon you, shake it off. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, 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 yes. Shake it off. 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 take it up. Amen. Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. My sister, turn your Bible to the book of Isaiah 61.
Or do you see Isaiah?
Everybody turn your Bible there.
It is
Isaiah 61. Verse 10. We're reading to 11 and then I'm done.
Isaiah 61, verse 10. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My soul shall be joyful in my God. For he has clothed me with the garment of salvation.
Oh! He said, for God has clothed me with the garment of salvation. Somebody wave an offering unto Jesus. You are saved. He says, I am clothed with a garment. You are no longer under any curse. You are no longer under any yoke. But the salvation power of God is upon you. It's upon you. Amen.